Hello students, today our topic is The Tempest, Act 4, Scene 1. Now first I'll talk about the plot development of Act 4, Scene 1. You find the main action in this scene is the mask. The mask leads to the union of two houses, Milan and Naples. It ends with the union of Ferdinand and Miranda. Marriage festivities are the main attraction of this scene. The mask is closely connected with the main action of the play. It is also a part of supernatural machinery. The conspiracy of Caliban ends in its failure. Act 4, Scene 1, Summary. Prospero is convinced that true love exists between Ferdinand and his daughter Miranda. So he frees Ferdinand of his hard labor. He gives his blessings to their engagement ceremony, but warns Ferdinand not to indulge in sex before marriage. If they do so, it will result in hate, disdain, and discord. Ferdinand makes a solemn pledge to honor the sanctity of love by all means. Prospero then orders Ariel to entertain them at this happy occasion. The entertainment takes place in the form of a mask. In this mask, Iris, the goddess of rainbow, Juno, the wife of Jupiter, and queen of gods who protect the sanctity of marriage, and Ceres, an earth goddess, seem to take part to provide entertainment to the couple. But according to Prospero's instructions, we come to know that these goddesses actually are illusionary. The spirits, including Ariel, perform the role of these goddesses to entertain Ferdinand and Miranda. Towards the end, there's a dance done by the spirits, and Prospero suddenly recalls Caliban's treacherous plot and orders to end the mask immediately. This surprises the young couple, and Miranda says that she has never seen her father so angry. Ferdinand is intelligent enough to understand that the mask has been performed by spirits. Prospero asks Ariel about the three drunkards. Ariel tells him that they were so drunk that they were striking the air and beating the earth. He had left them in the pond behind Prospero's cave. Prospero asks him to hang some colorful clothes on a line to distract them when they approach. Soon the three, Caliban, Trincolo and Stefano, spot the colorful clothes. Caliban is eager and impatient to get on with the murder of Prospero, but Trincolo and Stefano are attracted by the clothes and are indifferent. Prospero, the powerful magician, unleashes the spirits in the form of hounds to chase Caliban, Stefano and Trincolo away. Significance of the mask. In the mask scene, there are three central characters in Act 4, Scene 1. They are Iris, the goddess of rainbow. From biblical point of view, Iris represents hope. Then there is Juno, the queen of gods and goddesses. She represents riches, childbirth, and these types of blessings. Then there is Ceres, the goddess earth or goddess of agriculture. The mask is a play within a play. In The Tempest, Shakespeare has included two masks. In Act 3, there's a banquet scene. It is a dumb show that includes music, dance, dramatic gestures, and supernatural personages. The disappearance of the mask and Ariel appearing as a harpy, reminding Alonso and his companions about their crimes in order to make them regret and feel repentant. But in Act 4, Scene 1, the mask is mainly provided for entertainment. To celebrate the engagement ceremony of Ferdinand and Miranda, The Mask is an independent drama mainly consisting of music, song, dance, splendid costuming, and stage spectacle. It involves mythical characters like goddesses, and there's grand costume accompanied with music. In Act 4, Scene 1, the mask is very elaborate. It is arranged by Prospero, who summons the goddesses, which are actually spirits performing the role of goddesses, to entertain Ferdinand and Miranda at the engagement ceremony. Thus, it may be termed as engagement mask or betrothal mask. This mask is arranged by Ariel at the command of Prospero. The mask starts with the appearance of Iris, the goddess of rainbow, and Juno, the wife of supreme god Jupiter. Iris makes a long speech and summons Ceres, the goddess of agriculture and all the fruits that enrich the earth. Juno, the wife of Jupiter, joins Ceres and informs her that she has been summoned to bless the couple who have been engaged to each other and are likely to be married soon. Then Juno showers her blessings on the couple and wishes them a long life, riches, honor, many children, and happiness. Next, Ceres showers her blessings and wishes that the couple might have inexhaustible storehouse of corn, plenty of fruits, and everything else. Iris then gathers a large number of nymphs who join the reapers and perform a splendid dance. Then Prospero suddenly orders to end the spectacle of dance and song. Ferdinand wants to know if the entertainment provided to them was by the supernatural spirits. Prospero replies in the positive and remarks that everything in this universe has a transitory stay and it melts away in due course of time, just as the spirits who gave them entertainment with dance and song have melted into the thin air. So this Act 4, Scene 1 highlights one of the themes of the drama, that this earthly life is an illusion, and that is highlighted by the mask in Act 4, Scene 1. Though the mask is included to provide entertainment, it also serves a dramatic purpose. The love episode involving Ferdinand and Miranda has been made real and natural by the addition of the mask in the play. The mask also helps in furthering the development of this love episode. This romantic episode will reach its climax when Ferdinand's father Alonso showers his blessings on the young lovers. The mask included in the play isn't tuned with the general atmosphere of the play. Prospero, the great magician, has acquired powers over the supernatural spirits and gets all his tasks done with the help of the spirits. The whole play is dominated by supernatural machinery. Now, the mask arranged by Prospero involves spirits who appear as goddesses and fairies or nymphs. Thus, the mask becomes an integral part of the play, The Tempest. It should not be regarded as something irrelevant, as it cannot be taken away without disturbing the structure of the play, even though slightly. We have a feeling of wonder about the world of magic. Shakespeare, who represents himself as Prospero, shows his skill and command, especially from the point of view of stage management. This mass scene also highlights the theme of chastity, which is reinforced through the mask. Iris symbolizes hope and unites the earthly and heavenly, that any marriage should have the ideal union of both the attitude of being earthly successful and also from the spiritual point of dramatic significance of Act 4, Scene 1. Prospero is convinced of Ferdinand's true love for Miranda. He, however, as a father, takes pains to explain and warn Ferdinand against the gratification of his sensual desire. When the prince assures the worried father of his having no such intention, he presents a mask with the help of his spirits. The scene has threefold importance. Firstly, the marriage is agreed upon by Prospero. Secondly, the entertainment provided by Prospero regarding the engagement ceremony of Ferdinand and Miranda. And thirdly, a subplot pertaining to the conspiracy hatched by Caliban against Prospero's life and its failure. Now let us take these factors point by point. In the first case, the major subplot is almost over with Prospero's formal consent to his daughter's marriage with Ferdinand. In the second case, a mask, a popular entertainment in Shakespeare's period, is presented at the suggestion of King James I to celebrate the marriage of his daughter Elizabeth. So, the dramatists introduced Ferdinand and Miranda to represent the royal groom and bride, to entertain the royalty and nobility. In the third case, the conspirators are taught a lesson by Prospero. The supernatural atmosphere is reinforced with the presentation of the mask. The comic elements are also present. Stefano, Trincolo, and Caliban are drunk and wet because they have been dancing in a stinking pool of water. Both Stefano and Trincolo are lamenting the loss of the precious liquor. Both are attracted toward the gaudy garments hung upon a line. They forget their evil plan and are busy in collecting the worthless stuff. Prospero inflicts all sorts of punishment on them. This is hilarious and farcical. There is a wonderful passage of poetry spoken by Prospero, which reminds us that this world is really an illusion. Nothing is permanent. The human existence is just like a dream. His comment on Caliban's character is also appropriate. The half-monster is really a devil whom no education can perhaps reform. Ariel serves Prospero efficiently. He only makes arrangements for the presentation of the mask. He only leads the three plotters into the stinking pond. He hangs the gaudy garments on a line. He also orders the goblins to attack the three plotters in form of hounds. Ariel is an instrument through whom Prospero fulfills his will. Without him, half of these might not have been achieved. The play is a Christian play because the theme of repentance and reconciliation is also highlighted. In arranging Miranda's marriage with Ferdinand, Prospero is trying to reconcile Milan with Naples. Prospero gets annoyed when Ariel demands freedom, but he is strict and trusts Ariel, while he totally distrusts Calamon. Critical remarks on Act 4, Scene 1. Shakespeare chooses Juno, Ceres, and Iris, while Venus and her son Cupid are predominantly absent, since they symbolize passionate love, whereas the dramatist wanted to portray innocence. But he does make goddesses appear who promise both prosperity and fertility, appropriate for a royal couple. The two good characters of the play, Gonzalo and Ferdinand, talk in glowing terms about the island. To them, it appears as generous and benevolent, which can shower its blessings on them. In sharp contrast, Trincolo and Stefano want to be rulers of the island and to defile its magnificence for their own material gains. Nature's bounty was a recurring theme in Shakespearean pastoral plays. The two courtiers, Stefano and Trincolo, are shown even lower than Caliban. The two courtiers have all the outer show of civilization. If they appear much inferior to Caliban, it shows that outer appearances can be deceptive. Caliban manages to retain some traits of intelligence because of the unpolluted environment that had surrounded him for some years. In this scene, Prospero, at the end of the mask, says that we are such stuff as dreams are made of. This is Shakespeare at his poetic best in the play. Why does the mask end abruptly? Falling could be the reasons. The mask can be shortened without any break in action whenever it becomes dull and uninspiring. Secondly, in spite of the happiness of the occasion of the engagement of Miranda and Ferdinand, Prospero would not lose sight of reality again. Their reality is a threat to his life. He deals with it at the end of the act. Prospero, in the beginning, warned Ferdinand about the virtues of marriage. Apart from being Miranda's father and teacher, he is also the moral and religious teacher of the island. He intends to establish a moral order by imparting moral instructions to the stranded courtiers.